Hello beautiful people, my name is Mariela Paulino and I'm making this video because I get asked at least once a day, how do you hear? You have your hearing disability? Really? Really, really? Well, yes, really, really. And while I by no means mind telling people how I hear, I thought, maybe I should just make a video to kind of educate people on what having a cochlear implant is all about. So, one of the first things I want to say about a cochlear implant is that it is by no means a perfect system. Just because you can hear sound does not necessarily mean you will be able to understand sound. But that's a video that I hope to talk, that's a subject I hope to cover later on down the road. Because, come on people, one thing at a time. So, cochlear implants and how they work. So, for normal hearing, hearing is made up of three parts. It's the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear is basically your ear, the physical manifestation of your ear. So, when sound travels to your ear, it goes from your outer ear to the middle ear, which is the ear canal, and then it goes down to the cochlea. Now, the cochlea is like a snail shell. Here. Now let's focus on that. The cochlea is like a snail shell that has hairs that basically move around in vibrations when you hear. Now for me, I lost my hearing because of meningitis. So a lot of my hairs were damaged because of the meningitis making me deaf in both ears. How I hear is when you're talking to me, if you're talking to me right now, sound will travel to here. This is like a small microphone, and sound is going to the microphone down to the processor, which is here. The processor basically changes sound into brain language, which is just a bunch of electrodes. And then from the processor, sound will travel to the outside magnet right here. The magnet is like a refrigerator magnet. It can come off and on. And I take it off when I go shower, because having a cochlear implant is just like having a Bluetooth. You don't shower with your Bluetooth. I hope you don't. And when you go to sleep, I also take it off. So, sound travels from the microphone to the processor to the outside magnet to a magnet that I have inside, right outside the cochlea. So, the magnet inside has a cord that goes inside the cochlea to replace the hair cells that were destroyed. So, sound travels from the microphone to the processor to the outside magnet to the inside magnet to the cochlea to the hearing nerve to the brain. Happy face here. And the same speed that you're speaking. The only difference in the way that I hear and the way that you hear is that first, I'm only hearing on my right side. So that's why usually when I'm with friends or in a social environment, I will be getting on people's left side because I will be hearing on my right side. So that's something that a lot of people have noticed because I'm always trying to get on the left side. It's also a little bit harder for me to be able to hear someone when they're on my left side just because I'll have to turn my head to be able to understand what they're saying. It's just a little bit more difficult. One thing that I think is very important is that just because a person has a cochlear implant does not mean that they hear in a robotic tone, I guess. A cochlear implant has almost as many frequencies as a normal person. The only difference is that I am not able to hear all frequencies. With that said, there are some frequencies, some sounds that I am not able to hear or that are very difficult for me to hear because they are so soft. For example, the TH sound, like think or thousand or thought, that's a very, very soft sound and I often don't catch it. But because of hearing therapy and speech therapy, I have become aware of how to say that sound and how to kind of catch myself in my speech and become aware of where that sound goes. In addition to that, a person that has normal hearing, if I was talking to you right now and we were in a very crowded and busy restaurant, if I was talking to you, your brain has the ability to subconsciously focus on my voice and filter out the background noise. But for me, it's a little different because when I hear all the sounds coming in together at the same time, which makes it very difficult because when I'm talking, I'm hearing all these sounds going on at the same time. And it's my job to filter out and find a way to hear you and to filter out your voice as you're speaking. That's why it's very important for me to be able to lip read. Say, for example, you're telling me something like, come here. I'm hearing you say, come here. I will also be reading your lips say, come here. And I will also be watching out for context clues like, come here. So those kind of things are very, very helpful. I would also very, very much appreciate if you don't cover your mouth because that will make it very hard. It's also one of my gifts, one of my talents, that I'm a very good lip reader. So if you're all the way across in the cafeteria and I have access to your lips, I will probably be able to understand what you're saying. But that's just my way of eavesdropping. You know, I know a lot of little secrets here and there. It's also very important to speak like a normal person. You do not have to speak slowly. You don't have to yell either because I'm right here and I can hear you. Okay? So, also, if at some point in time you're calling out to me and then keep walking, I'm not ignoring you most of the time. And if I am, I'll probably be like, I'm ignoring you, so I'm just going to keep walking. But please, if at some point I'm walking and you like yell out my name and then keep walking, I'm not being rude. I just probably didn't hear. So try to wave, try to catch my attention in some other way. Also, try not to eat food when you're talking because that kind of messes up the signature in the mouth, and it's not very nice. So yeah, that's pretty much how I hear. If you have any questions, concerns, words of wisdom, don't hesitate to talk or to ask me or yeah. You say hello, okay? That's how cooking improv works. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope there's something new. Bye-bye.